I'd ask you from the outset of today's proceedings that the formality of the ceremony be respected and applause given only at the times requested. To begin our ceremony today, I'd ask you to stand in silence as our official party enters the hall.
Good morning and welcome to the St. Columba's Catholic College Year 11 Awards Ceremony. This is indeed a very special event which recognises the achievements of students in Year 11. I now ask you to remain standing and with respect listen to our national anthem, Advance Australia Fair.
Australians are led up. Rejoice, for we are one and free. We've golden soil and wealth foretold. Our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty.
As we gather today, we show our respect and acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, the Darug and Gundungurra nations, their elders past and present on which this gathering takes place. Please be seated. To commence our ceremony this morning, I'd like to invite our college captains to lead us in prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, we give thanks for your coming into our life as we approach Advent. May we continue to live lives that reflect your kingdom of justice, love, and humility. Amen.
We reflect on the times when we have not opened our hearts to God's love. For the times we have ignored the needs of others, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For the times we have failed to be peacekeepers, Christ have mercy. For the times we have refused to accept responsibility for our anger and arrogance, Lord have mercy.
God of mercy, create in us hearts ready to serve so that we will value, encourage, and recognize others as a reflection of you. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of the peacemakers, may all students know your loving plan, acting justly, loving tenderly, and walking humbly with you, our God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of the pure of heart, inspire us as you inspired St. Columba to make the best use of the talents you have given us. We especially give thanks for those students receiving awards today. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Together, please join with me in praying our college prayer. Loving God, you share goodness with us and teach us what is right. Help us to care for all people, to act justly, to love tenderly, and to walk humbly with you. St. Columba, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I'd now like to invite our college principal, Mr. Ryan, to deliver his address.
Thanks, Ross. Well, good morning, Year 12. It's lovely to see all your beautiful faces. And to our parents who are watching this at home today, I'd like to welcome you too. And I'm so sorry you couldn't be here for this beautiful occasion. But in welcoming you to this special ceremony, I ask that we each give thanks to our God, the God of all creation, and acknowledge with the deepest of respect the original custodians of this beautiful land, the Darug and Gundagara people. Students, you know as well as I do that an individual excels because of many factors, not the least of which is the number of people who contribute to our success. We never do it alone. People like your parents, who in their wisdom have taught you that the real purpose for us gathering today is because each of us knows deep within our hearts that we've been called to become the best possible person we can be. And ceremonies like this one reminds us of that calling, a calling that requires us to commit ourselves each day to acknowledge and use the gifts and talents that our God has given to us, so that we may become the person He has created us to be. Albert Einstein said this: "The secret to success lies in a person's ability to persist." He also said, "It's not that I'm smart, it's just that I stay with problems longer." Students, it's about persistence, not giving up and not listening to all those little voices within you that tell you that you can't do it, that you're not as intelligent as someone else. It's about believing with all your might that you can do it. The only way to achieve success in our lives, which is ultimately the purpose for all of us, is to make positive choices every single day and to become an active participant in our own learning. In the end, all these little choices and actions all add up. Learning is much more than getting all of straight A's and lots of certificates. It's a commitment. And it's the sum of all the small choices you make each day. Because everything we do, everything that we do in our lives is all about the learning. And always having high expectations of ourselves and of others. So to each of you today, I want you to know that your success honours everybody here. It honours your parents, it honours your friends, it honours the whole school community. And we thank you for your efforts and the commitment that each of you have made to become the person God has created you to be. And Year 12, I ask you never to forget this. Stay with the problem. Don't give up. Don't find things, when you find things difficult, don't find yourself saying to yourself, I can't do this. Find ways through the problem. And that goes for every aspect of your life, not just academic work, but all aspects of your work. But in conclusion, I just simply want to say, be the person that God has created you to be. And may God bless each and every one of you always. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ryan. I'd now like to invite Ms. Belinda Pranjic, our Leader of Wellbeing, to assist Mr. Ryan in presenting the College Gold and Platinum Awards. So students seeking a Gold Award must have already attained their Silver Award. They must set and achieve goals relating to academic achievement, college community service, and wider community service over a minimum period of 2 terms. It is my great pleasure to announce Emily Willis as having attained her College Gold Award. Students seeking a Platinum Award must have already attained their Gold Award. They must set and achieve goals relating to academic achievement, complete 2 terms of college community service and 2 terms of wider community service. This award must be completed for a minimum period of 1 year. It's my great pleasure to announce the following students as having attained their College Platinum Award. Talia Rust. And Sophia Hammond. Would you please join with me? I'd now like to call upon Ms. Belinda Pranjic, Leader of Wellbeing, Year 11, and our College Principal, Mr. Ryan, to present the Academic Achievement Awards for 2021.
Thank you. Good morning, students. It is my pleasure to announce the Academic Achievement recipients for 2021. These awards will be presented to students who have obtained either second or third place in each course. The certificates are a great accomplishment and will identify the subject when the student is presented to Mr. Ryan. I would ask you to please hold your applause to the end. James Batinsky, Academic Achievement, English Standard, Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Who is not here today. Sebastian Boucher, Academic Achievement for Music 1. Benjamin Boyer, Academic Achievement for Community and Family Studies. Jasmine Cook, Academic Achievement, Studies in Catholic Thought and Visual Arts. Sarah Darby, Academic Achievement, Personal Development, Health and Physical Education, and Studies of Religion 2. Ethan Dempsey, Academic Achievement, Industrial Technology, Timber. Rachel Doughty, Academic Achievement in Design and Technology. Marius Edmonds, Academic Achievement in Chemistry, Mathematics Advanced, Mathematics Extension 1, and Physics. Audrey Gauci, Academic Achievement in Visual Arts. Curtis Glassford, Academic Achievement in Industrial Technology, Timber. Sean Gretch-Axiak, academic achievement in agriculture. Clay Griffiths, academic achievement in English studies, who is not here today. Sophia Hammond, academic achievement in English advanced. Charlotte Harris, academic achievement in society and culture. Joshua Harrison, academic achievement in mathematics extension 1. Kiara Hill, academic achievement in design and technology, who is not here today. Liam Kerr, academic achievement in chemistry and physics. Pang Ying Ho, academic achievement in English advanced. Amelia Konstantinov, academic achievement in studies of religion 2. Bridget Lloyd Williams, academic achievement in English studies. Arid McCuster Monk, academic achievement in agriculture, who is not here today. Holly McKelvey, academic achievement in mathematics extension 1. Rose Meal, academic achievement in biology, English extension 1, mathematics advanced, studies of religion 1. Nurses Maradian, academic achievement in business studies. Isabella Asinga Minta, academic achievement in studies of Catholic thought, who is not here today. Oliver Rizzuti, academic achievement in legal studies, mathematics standard 2. Thomas Rizzuti, academic achievement in legal studies and modern history. Talia Rust, academic achievement in ancient history, English extension 1. Freya van Rossum, academic achievement in biology. Lauren Walford, academic achievement in community and family studies, society and culture. Callum Wormsley, academic achievement in mathematics standard 2, not here today. Gemma Ward, academic achievement in English standard. And Flynn Weston, academic achievement in music 1 and studies of religion 1, who is not here today. Could you please put your hands together for these students?
I now invite Cornelius Appel to come forward for our musical item. Cornelius will be performing Everglow by Coldplay. Please welcome Cornelius to the stage.
Thank you.
Thank you, Cornelius, for your beautiful performance. I would now like to call upon our college principal, Mr. Ryan, to present the Academic Achievement Awards for 2021. It is my great pleasure to present the Academic Excellence Awards to those students who have been ranked first place in their courses based on their preliminary HSC assessment. These students will be awarded with an Academic Excellence Medallion and Certificate. The following students have achieved first place in one of their courses, and I'd ask you please to hold your applause until the end. Sebastian Boucher, Industrial Technology Timber. Benjamin Boyer, Music One. Neve Canning, English Standard. Curtis Glassford, Design and Technology. Charlotte Harris, Ancient History. Emma Hennessy, English Studies. Kiara Hill, Society and Culture. Kiara is absent today. Ella Laurent, Hospitality. Vaughan Philpott, Hospitality. Max Rennenberg, Construction. Oliver Rizzuti, Business Studies. Freya Van Rossum, Primary Industries. Flynn Weston, Modern History. Flynn is away today. William Zammit, Fitness. And William is also away today. Can you please put your hands together for these students? The following students have achieved first place in two of their courses: Jasmine Cook for English Extension 1 and Legal Studies. Sophia Hammond, for Ancient History and Modern History. Holly McElveen, for Community and Family Studies and Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Rose Mile, for Agriculture and English Advanced. And Talia Rust, Studies in Catholic Thought and Visual Arts. Students, please put your hands together for these award recipients. The following student has achieved first place in three of their courses: Thomas Rizzuti, Business Studies, Mathematics Standard 2, and Studies of Religion 2. Please put your hands together for Thomas. The following student has achieved first place in six out of a possible seven of their courses. For first place in Biology, Chemistry, Mathematics Extension 1, Mathematics Advanced, Physics, and Studies of Religion 1, would you please put your hands together for Pang Ying Ko? A warm congratulations to all of our award recipients. I'd now move on to our Sporting Blue Awards. This is a premier award for students who represent the college through selection into a state or national team as a result of the New South Wales Triple C. This award is also presented to students who represent a sport at a state or national level without being part of the New South Wales Triple C. The College Sporting Blue Award acknowledges exceptional talent and commitment to sport. And I'd like now to congratulate the following students who have received a College Sporting Blue Award. And I'd ask you please to hold your applause until the end. For Amity Bus, Athletics National Championships. Unfortunately, Amity is away today. Hague Buckingham, National Swimming Champion in all comers. Alec Gleeson for New South Wales Cross Country Championships. Please put your hands together for Hague and Alec. Staff and students, that concludes our Year 11 Awards Ceremony for 2021. On behalf of Mr. Ryan, the college staff, and your parents and families who could not be present with you today, I would like to congratulate all of you on your outstanding achievements throughout what has been quite a challenging year. I would like to thank Mr. Ryan, Sean and Jasmine for leading us in prayer, Cornelius for your wonderful music performance, and all the staff for their assistance with today's presentation. I'd ask you now please to stand silently as we listen to our college hymn, Columba, as our official party leaves the hall.
Thank you, Year 12. Please be seated. I'd once again like to congratulate all our award recipients today, but also thank each and every one of you for your participation and involvement in our ceremony today. I'll now hand you over to Ms. Pranjic for dismissal out to recess.
Thank you, seniors. Can I please ask the back three rows to stand and you can head to recess?
Thank you.
Thank you, and can we have the next few rows, please?
Thank you. Wait, what? Do you want me to sit here?
So I would ask you from the outset of today's proceedings, again, that the formality of the ceremony be respected and applause given only at the times requested. So to begin our ceremony today, I ask you to stand in silence as our official party enters the hall.
Good morning and welcome to the St. Columba's Catholic College Year 10 Award Ceremony. This is indeed a very special event which recognises the achievements of students in Year 10. I ask you now to remain standing and with respect listen to our national anthem, Advance Australia Fair.
Australians are let us rejoice, for we are one and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil, our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty, rich and
be seated. To commence our ceremony this morning, I would like to invite Leo Curry and Amelia Sinnott to lead us in prayer.
In prayer today, we show our respect and acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, the Darug and Gundungurra nations, of their elders past and present, on which this gathering takes place. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. God of heaven and earth, nurture us in spirit and of forgiveness, hope and joy as we strive to be channels of Christ's love and peace.
As we listen to your word, Lord, may it speak to our hearts and deepen our faith. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Prepare the way of the Lord. Go up on a high mountain, joyful messenger to Zion. Shout with a loud voice, joyful messenger to Jerusalem. Shout without fear, say to the towns of Judah, here is your God. Here is the Lord coming with power, his arm subduing all things to him. The prize of his victory is with him, his trophies all go before him. He is like a shepherd feeding his flock, gathering lambs in his arms, holding them against his breast and leading them to rest with their mother ewes. This is the word of the Lord.
Lord, awaken us to your presence as we open our hearts to you. In response to each petition, together we will pray, God of peace, hear our prayer. We pray for the parents, students, and staff of our school community. May we discover in ourselves your treasure and put to good use the qualities you entrust to us.
God of peace, hear our prayer.
We pray for the people in our world who are suffering. Give us the courage to be your hands and voice in the world.
God of peace, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are ill in mind and body. May they feel Christ's presence and know that they are loved and valued.
We pray for the leaders of our church, especially Pope Francis and Bishop Vincent. May they continue to call us to see the face of Christ in your people. We pray for all community elders and political leaders. May they recognize and serve the neediest within their communities.
Please join with me in saying our college prayer. Loving God, you share goodness with us and teach us what is right. Help us to care for all people, to act justly, to love tenderly, and to walk humbly with you, our God. St. Columba, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I now call forward Mr. Ryan, our college principal, to deliver his address. Please welcome Mr. Ryan.
Well, good morning, staff and students.
Good morning, Mr. Ryan.
And a very special good morning to the parents who are watching today. I'm so sorry that they couldn't be with us. But as you know, with the restrictions placed upon us, it was impossible to have them here today. In welcoming you to this very special ceremony, I ask you to give thanks to our God, the God of all creation, and acknowledge with the deepest of respect the original custodians of this beautiful and great land, the Darug and Gundagara people. Students, in preparing today, I was thinking very much about how success moulds each person. How an individual's success represents all the work that a number of people have done, not just the individual. Those people who are receiving awards today know for a fact that it wasn't just their work that enabled them to achieve what they've achieved. It was the love that their parents have given them and continues to give them, and it was also the care and concern that each of you have for them, your friendship, that enabled them to succeed. So today, as we think about what success is all about and what achievement is all about, I want you all to remember that your achievements, no matter what they are the sum of everybody else's love, care, concern, and work for you. People like your parents who in their wisdom have taught you that the real purpose for us gathering today is because of each of us knows deep within our hearts that we've been called to become the best possible person we can be. And ceremonies like this one reminds us of that calling, a calling that requires us to commit ourselves each day to acknowledge and use the gifts and talents that our God has given to us, so that we may become the person he has created us to be. I know many of you and all of us should have heard of Albert Einstein, and we know he was an incredibly intelligent man. I think if you were to read his story, you'd be shocked about how well he did at school. He didn't do well at all. But the reality is, he talked about what success was for him. And he said, "It's not that I'm smart, it's just that I stay with problems longer." And yes, students, it's about persisting, not giving up, and not listening to all those little voices inside your head that tell you that you can't do something, or that you're not intelligent enough, that someone's more intelligent than you. It's about believing with all your might that you can do it. But you've got to believe it. And when you find yourself listening to that little voice within yourself telling you that you can't do something, challenge it. Challenge it to say, "I can do it." Look, even myself, you know, even at my age, I hear that little voice sometimes saying to me, "You can't do it, Paul." And sometimes I get anxious about the fact that what lies ahead and what I'm to do and how I'm to do it and whether I'll achieve it or not. But I've got to stop myself from listening to that little voice. And I want you all to do the same thing. And I promise you it'll make the difference. The only way we achieve success in our lives, which is ultimately a purpose for all of us, we all want to achieve success, is to make positive choices every day and to become an active participant in our own learning. In the end, all these little choices and actions all add up. Learning is much more than getting all of straight A's. I mean, it's wonderful when you do, and lots of certificates as well. But it's a commitment and is the sum of all the small choices you make every single day. The choice to get out of bed at a certain time, the choice to dress in your school uniform, the choice to go into class with a positive attitude, the choice to sit down and do your homework or learning prep at home, and to just get it done and to do it well, the choice to spend time with your friends, the choice to watch television, all the little choices that we make every day. It's the sum of all those choices. So when you think about whether or not you are successful or not, look at all the choices you're making and ask yourself a very simple question. Are these the best choices I can make? And please don't be fooled. Every single person in this room, every adult, every child, it's the same for all of us. We have to keep asking ourselves that very simple question. Because, students, as you've heard me say 1,000 times, everything we do in our life is about learning. Everything. And having high expectations of ourselves, you've got to have them of yourself first and of each other. So to each of you, I want you to know that your success honours every single person here and in the school and your families and your friends and your relatives, and we want to thank you for your efforts and the commitment that each one of you have made to become the person God has created you to be. And may God bless each and every one of you always, particularly as you walk the journey of life. Because as we walk this journey, we're never alone. He walks with us every step of the way. God bless you, Year 10, and thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ryan. I would now like to invite Mr. Josh Hunter, Leader of Wellbeing, to assist Mr. Ryan in presenting the College Silver and Platinum Awards. Students seeking a Silver Award must have attained a minimum of 5 Bronze Awards. They must set and achieve goals related to academic achievement and college community service over a minimum period of 10 weeks. It is my great pleasure to announce the following students as having attained their College Silver Awards for 2021, and I'd ask you please to hold your applause until the end. Sebastian Andrews. Tisha Delfsma. And Emily Walker. Please put your hands together for these students. Students seeking a Platinum Award must have already attained their Gold Award. They must set and achieve goals relating to academic achievement, complete 2 terms of college community service, and 2 terms of wider community service. This award must be completed for a minimum period of 1 year. It is my great pleasure to announce the following students as having attained their College Platinum Awards for 2021. Leo Curry, and Luca Pensarini. Please join with me in congratulating these students. I would now like to call upon Mr. Josh Hunter, Leader of Wellbeing Year 10, and our College Principal, Mr. Ryan, to present the Year 10 Academic Achievement Awards for either Semester 1 or 2.
Good morning. It's my pleasure to recognise the following students who have attained Academic Achievement Award for Semester 1 or 2. These students have obtained 4 or more A's in either Semester 1 or 2 report this year. Lily Brosnan, Semester 2. Piper Bruce, Semester 2. Neve Burns, Semester 2. Lucy Dawson, Semester 1. Baden Gerlach, Semester 1. Charles Green, Semester 2. Misha Kling, Semester 1. Jacob Lestrell-Braid, Semester 2. Natalia Maradian, Semester 2. Bridget Neal, Semester 2. Connor O'Leary, Semester 2. William Richardson, Semester 2. Noah Semelok, Semester 2. Please put your hands together for these students.
Thank you, Mr. Hunter, and congratulations to our Academic Achievement Award recipients. I now invite Chloe Corbett to come forward for our musical item, Song in the Night by Salzedo. Please welcome Chloe to the stage.
Thank you.
Please thank Chloe once again. That was fantastic. Absolutely magnificent. Academic Excellence Awards and medallions are presented to students in Year 10 who have attained four or more A's in both Semester 1 and Semester 2 reports this year. This is an outstanding academic achievement. I'd now call upon Mr. Josh Hunter, Leader of Wellbeing for Year 10, and Mr. Ryan to present the Year 10 Academic Excellence Awards.
It is my pleasure to recognise the following students who have attained an Academic Excellence Award in Year 10. Olive Baubley. Georgia Bradshaw. Ruby Flanagan. Kayla Goodwin. Lachlan Hanley. Dominique Hogan. Kayla Hurley. Emma Hislop. Edward James. Scarlett Judd. Sky O'Neill. Amelia Sinnott. Georgia Vermark. And Claudia Wedesvela. Please put your hands together for these students.
It's now my pleasure to announce the VET Academic Achievement recipients for 2021. These awards will be presented to students who have achieved outstanding results in their VET subjects. Aidan Machen, Construction, Semester 1 and 2. Thomas Manwaring, Construction, Semester 1 and 2. And Thomas is not here today. Claudia Vedesvela, Hospitality, Semester 1 and 2. Charlotte Croft, Hospitality, Semester 1. Piper Bruce, Hospitality, Semester 2. Charles Shingles, Primary Industries, Semester 1 and 2. And Charles is absent today. Olivia Griggs, Primary Industries, Semester 1. Oscar Baltons, Primary Industries, Semester 2. So would you please join with me in congratulating our VET HSC course recipients today. Students who study elective Japanese classes have had an opportunity to participate in the Education Perfect Languages World Championships this year. Over 200,000 students participated in the championships from all around the world. So it's my pleasure to recognise the following students who have attained an award for their performance in the Education Perfect Languages World Championships. Amelia Sinnott, who placed herself in the top 4.93% of competitors. Lachlan Hanley, who placed himself in the top 4.34% of competitors. Tisha Delfsma placed herself in the top 3.07% of competitors. So would you please congratulate our recipients of the Education Perfect Languages World Championship Awards. So staff and students, and to our parents who are watching via the live stream, that concludes our Year 10 Awards Ceremony for 2021. On behalf of Mr. Ryan, the college staff, and your parents and families who could not be here today, I'd like to congratulate you all on your outstanding achievements throughout what has been a very challenging year. I'd like to thank Mr. Ryan, Leo and Amelia for leading us in prayer, Chloe for her wonderful performance, and to all the staff for their assistance in today's ceremony. I'd now ask you all to stand and listen to our college hymn, Columba, as the official party leaves the hall.
Thank you, Year 10. Please be seated.